favorite thing about peak week is not calling it peak week. It's just another week for me to just keep doing the same thing I do every single day, the entire prep, and just show up and being consistent. That's my favorite thing, is just seeing everything come together from just doing the same things over and over again. So when it comes to my Olympia preps, every single year I move out with my coach. We're together every day, multiple times a day. Just really kind of hammering out the details and getting everything together to make sure that when I get on stage, I'm better than I was the year before. Every single year, and after 6 Olympia titles, it gets harder, but it's easier to do when we're together all the time. He's able to see what's happening, not just through videos or through the phone or anything like that. He's able to see in person what it looks like, because a body in person, a body on camera, those are two different bodies. So he's able to manipulate everything as he sees fit in person in real time. And so that's the benefit to moving out with him and just really being able to be trained by him every day, because I train myself for the rest of the year. He guides me and then I just do my own training, but he allows me to just be the athlete, and he does everything from the food, the nutrition, the cardio. I don't have to think, I just move. And that's probably the best thing for me, because I'm an overthinker. Like for us, our workouts would be like this. Back home, I'll be in that bad boy 45 minutes an hour when I don't need to be. So it's about tailoring down, and he guides me and does all that and just runs the show. That's why you gotta get your good coach. My other favorite thing about peak week, I get to see my family. My husband comes into town on Thursday, my parents are here, and it just signifies the final stretch of having to live 3 months with this man every year, my forever roommate. But it's kind of like, oh wow, like I'm actually get to go back to my other home now and back to regular life. So it's like two different lives. You just bounce back from one to the other.
Yeah, she just gotten, I call it weirder, but she's got more and more detail, which obviously makes my job a lot easier. It makes it to where we can function really well. We read each other's minds. Like a lot of times I'll say something and she was about to say it. So it's definitely, I guess I would say it's gotten easier. Give me 3 more. Still harder, because obviously we're always trying to improve, and trying to improve something that's been successful the last 6 years can be challenging, but at the same time it's fun. You know, we nitpick things. This year we work a little bit on shoulders, calves, some of the small details that probably most people don't pay attention to, and yeah, been good.
To be defending my title for the 6th time, you can't really put words to it. It's it's become a habit. So I always saw this one quote that said, excellence is a habit. And I've truly embodied that, and it becomes to where, that's why I said I don't believe in peak week, it's another week. Olympia Day is another day for me to do what I've been doing this entire time, and that's keep showing up for myself, keep representing for everybody who believes in me, and keep showing what me and my coach are able to accomplish every single year. And every single year is that, just showing up for me and my coach and making sure that everything he's invested in me, I put on the stage. He does a lot of the work, I do a lot of the work, we come together and we make sure that we showcase what that is on stage. I felt excellent overall coming into this Olympia. It feels so calm. I just feel excited. It's the best my body has ever felt. And as the years just keep going by, I've been doing this for over 17 years now. So being able to keep showing up and keep showing out is really, really great. But it's a testament to, again, consistency, and it's a testament to up leveling the consistency. So like, there's consistent, and then you add new things on that are gonna be better and make you better. And so for me this season, I focused on, like what Coach said, even more details. Like I get very, very neurotic about the details, because the details are what sets you apart. There's not any wide changes I have to make to my physique, so the details are what keep it fresh, what keep me motivated to keep getting better, keep pushing, never staying just like, oh, I won the title, so I should win it again. Like, when you start thinking like that, It's over with. You can't build a dynasty thinking that you're perfect. Otherwise, guaranteed there's gonna be somebody right behind you ready to take your spot. And I'm not trying to let that happen. So in order for me to keep pushing forward, every single Olympia I get done, I'm right back to the beginning. Every single time. I'll give myself that night, and since I know I'm not done, all right, what's next? What's the next detail I'm gonna focus on? Coach and I'll go through pictures. I want more of this. I want cleaner lines here. I want this like this. I want this smaller. I want this with more pop. We analyze every single year, and it's a never-ending circle. And for some, that can be detrimental, but for people who are really stable and on this quest for perfection, even if it's never attained, but you can strive for perfection. You can use perfectionism as a positive thing. It gets a negative connotation, but it can really be a positive if this is stable and you use it to propel you and not drag you down. Like, I'm very aware of what I've accomplished, but I know there's something better. And you don't know how much better it can be until you push yourself. In order to push yourself, you have to remain humble enough to know that you can be better. So I focus on that, focus on those details, and just nitpick and find anything that'll just keep setting me apart. And that's what I've done this entire prep. And it's gonna be interesting to see, because like I said, I dress like this the whole entire time. I know what my abs look like and my front pose, that's it. But in terms of anything else, I don't look at myself. All of that is for my coach to say, hey, you look good, that's all I worry about. As long as he thinks I look good, we good to go. And so I'm always excited to see what it looks like when I get off stage, because that's when all the pictures come in. It's like, oh, that's what I look like. That looks cool. And so you see kind of what the work actually looks like on stage. So this year is gonna be good. I'm very excited about it. I think it's a new look, a different look, an even better look. So really excited to showcase that on Friday. So every year I do a social media cleanse where no Instagram, no TikTok, no YouTube, no work emails. I stopped working about 3 weeks out in terms of my clients. I'll still run my show businesses and my other businesses like that, where I can kind of pull back the details, but I make sure that at least 3 weeks, 21 days is just my time. Because people get so caught up in, especially if you're a giving person like myself, if you're giving, giving, giving to everybody, there's a certain point where you gotta be like, hey, this is for me. And for me, bodybuilding is for me at the end of the day. When you take away all the nits and grannies, it's great to be motivated for everybody, be a motivator for everybody, an inspiration for everybody, but that all starts with showing up for myself. And I can only do that and be my best self if I pour all my energy into me. So at the end of preps, I stopped working on a large scale. The very end, the last week and a half to a week, no social media, because I don't need anybody else's energy. Like, I cut out anybody else's energy that isn't my coach or anybody who I have to see. Even my closest friends, they already know I go into silent mode. We don't need to talk until the show is over, because it's my time to focus on what I gotta do. And that's how I've been able to do what I've done and make history every single year, is because I take that little bit of time. A week and a half, what is that? 10 days? 10 days out of 365, sometimes 364, to focus on myself. And so that's what my social media cleanse is about. It's like not having to respond to a bunch of different people and take in so much and consume so much. You just kind of filter out everything, and it's just you, the gym, your goals, and your food. So that's worked for me so far. I've been doing that way for the last 8 years, and I've noticed a huge difference. And every single time I just get to feel so calm, so at peace, and sit with myself. A lot of people can't sit with themselves, but I feel like if you're trying to take these preps and turn them into bigger life lessons about yourself, you gotta be able to sit with yourself in these moments where it's just you and the work. So I found that's been amazing for me these last years, almost a decade. The rest of the week tends to pick up. Wednesday is pretty calm. Thursday is when I start getting hit. We got the press conference, meet and greet. The rest of my family comes in. We also have athlete check-ins. That's when everything starts really kind of falling into place on Thursday. And the physical work, like this type of cardio, cuts down depending on what my body does. We cut back on cardio and lifting and kind of rest in that aspect, but you're not really resting because you still have to be on and socialize and do everything you need to do as a champion. So the real work starts Thursday. And then go to bed at like 9, wake up, get on stage and do what I came here to do. And then once that's done, I can kind of just take it down and just assess everything, look through the pictures, get back on social media. And that's when the next job starts of responding to everybody, getting back on my post, picking up all my businesses again, because we have a show coming up. My first pro show is coming up in April. I have my third annual NPC Cydney Gillon Peach Classic coming up again in May. So this is my next year is packed. So I don't have time because I've already taken 3 weeks off. As soon as I get off stage, hit the ground running, right back to business. So I even start back working on Monday. So it's really right back to business once this after this week, yeah.